Dash the Stars, Cab Hunter, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, from Taxi, Mary Lou Henner, Dick Martin, and Fanny Flagg, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 78. And now, here's the star of Match Game 78, Gene River.
Thank you for joining us.
And thank you for joining us.
You all ready to have a go at it here?
Yes. Bit of a go?
All right. Off we go to Scotland Yard. Let's say hello to Mike Graham and Cheryl Crisp. Okay, now, Mike is the current champ. He's won a big bundle. He has $6,200 to his credit. And as you can see, it makes his mustache twitch. What are you going to do with all that money, Mike?
Buy hubcaps.
Buy hubcaps. Why hubcaps?
Wednesday, four of my hubcaps were stolen off my little car.
Really?
Yeah.
Would you like to tell us what neighborhood this happened in, sir? I'm taking names. Yeah.
In my neighborhood.
In your neighborhood. You're very popular there. Now, we just met Cheryl last time we got together, and she had her first round question and had her baptism of fire, and she knows how it goes now. And we'll continue with Mike in a moment or so, but right now we want you to see this, if you please. Here we go. Round one for Mike Graham. Cheryl has had her round one question, and this is the way his. Dumb Dora is really dumb. I tell you, yeah, you're all right. Here's the story. She wanted a bouncing baby boy, so she married a blank.
Baby boy.
Wanted a bouncing baby boy, so she married a blank. You're ready, right?
Charles was finished.
Mike Graham. Dumb Dora is really dumb. She wanted a bouncing baby boy, so she married a...
kangaroo.
A kangaroo is what he said. He said a kangaroo. What do you say to that?
Well, she's pretty dumb. I would say a kangaroo.
Kangaroo, too. All right, that's one for him.
Well, I figured there was a lot of discrimination in that area. It would be hard to find someone to marry you, but I said basketball player.
They bounce around a lot, and they're used to dribbling and all that. Yeah.
I said a baseball player, a ball player.
A ball player.
No, but basketball players dribble.
Yeah, I didn't think that could be a basketball player, too. Just shut your mouth. Always correcting me.
Okay, Mary Lou, we come to you. She wanted a bouncing baby boy, so she married a...
Oh, if she's dumb, she's got to marry a kangaroo.
A kangaroo. Super Mike Graham. Show us your kangaroo.
I frankly do not approve of those kinky relationships between... lady and kangaroo, so she married a rubber man in a circus.
The rubber man in the circus. The India rubber man.
Who incidentally was kinky.
Right.
I'm in trouble.
Why?
I matched Brett. Basketball player.
Basketball player. Okay.
I'm in trouble.
So he picked up two, and now we'll go to round two. And Cheryl, again, you have a choice of A or B.
B again.
B it is. All right, let's see if she can catch up now. Rita said, I fried so bad in the sun today, Colonel Sanders made me an offer for my blanks. You understand? No, you don't understand. I fried so bad in the sun today, Colonel Sanders made me an offer for my blanks. Here we go.
Well, I guess maybe I don't want to have to...
Now, Cheryl. Rita said, I fried so bad in the sun today, Colonel Sanders made me an offer for my blanks.
For my boobs?
All right. Chicken breasts, one order of chicken breasts coming up. What do you say there, Tab?
I like the thighs myself.
Thighs. All right.
Well, I used the word that you used before, but then you know how they are. They like a lot of euphemisms on this show.
Yes.
The actual, right?
Right.
So I took that out and I stuck in boobs.
Okay. One for Cheryl. Yes.
Breasts.
Okay. Score is now tied 2-2. Mary Lou, Colonel Sanders made me an offer for my...
I've had many offers. Breasts.
Yeah.
I was one of the first to offer.
Oh, there it is. Fanny, you...
Thighs.
Well, it's, you know, it's white meat versus dark meat is the way it goes there. Okay, Cheryl has 4 now. Mike, you need 2 to tie and 4 to win. Tarzan said...
Arr!
No, he went... Oh, 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 oh. That's the way he went.
That's the way you go when we get to the motel.
That hurt.
And then you go like that, and that's the part I don't like.
May Tarzan I say said, something?
Yes.
Stick to the Jolly Green Giant question.
Tarzan said, never again, Tarzan, let hippie stay in treehouse. Him smoke my blank. Him smoke my blank. Never again let hippie stay in... Right, you got the idea. Do you have a quick mind?
Yes.
Him smoke my...
Oh, wait a minute.
Click everything. I don't think I play this one.
No, you don't play. Tab does not play. Mary Lou and Tab do not play because they were matched in the previous round. What? Already. Okay, Mike. Tarzan said, never again, Tarzan, let hippie stay in treehouse. Him smoke my blank.
My rug? Rug?
Rug.
Rug, R-U-G, rug.
You say rug? Tarzan no have rug in treehouse.
Tarzan have...
What kind of weird answer?
Tarzan have Jane in treehouse.
Right.
And Tarzan... What was the baby's name?
Boy.
Cheetah.
Boy. Boy.
Seymour.
Why are you stalling? You didn't write an answer.
Sure, I wrote an answer. I said, smoke my vine.
Smoke my vine. Him smoke my vine. You got the idea now? What do you say, Chuck?
Chuck said him smoke my vine.
Vine is the answer. Now, you must match the 2 remaining ones, Mike, to stay in the game and achieve a tie. Dick, it's up to you.
No, he smoked my rope.
My rope. So that means Cheryl Crisp wins the game and Fanny Advine. Come on down, Cheryl. Right there, if you would please, ma'am. Now, Mike, I'm glad you won some money. Nifty kid, peachy dancer, snappy dresser. $6,200 for old Mike Graham, the pilot. So long, Mike. We'll spin him off and spin a message for you. How do you feel? Here we go. Cheryl Crisp is up here for the first time. I'll answer your question later, sir. But right now, we got to do a little business with Cheryl. We polled a studio audience, Cheryl, not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Blank and dry. If you match the answer they wrote down most often, you get $500. For matching the second most popular answer, $250. And then for matching the third, you get $100. 3 of our 6 loonies will help.
Okay, Charles.
Wash and dry.
Wash and dry.
Dick.
High and dry.
Britt.
I knew she was going to pick on me third. I know that. See,
the third is tough. Brett?
Good and dry.
Good and dry.
Well, it's number 3. Now, I'm not going to have you whirling on me like that.
So you have good and dry, high and dry, wash and dry, the 3 that have been suggested. You can choose one of those or give us one of your own. What is your pleasure?
Wash.
Wash and dry is the one that Charles gave you. Let's find out if it's up there. May we see the $100 number? Soft and dry. That's a commercial product, I guess, isn't it? Here we go with a $250 number. Wash and dry. You got it. Congratulations. $250 more for you. We have a grand total of $350 now. What's under the big one?
High.
High. Aren't we all? Okay, Ari, slide it. High is right. High and dry. Well, listen, you won $250. It means the least you'll play for is $2,500. However, if you spin that wheel and get a lucky spin, you'll double your money, be playing for $5,000. If it stops in any of the Gold Star area there, it's all electronically controlled and measured, and it'll determine which star you're playing with and for how much. Give it a go. A good hard spin. Must make at least one revolution, and it barely did, but it did. Vermont, are you ready again?
Oh, gosh.
Are you nervous?
The pressure really gets on when that
yes,
happens.
Yes, it does. All right. Good luck to you, my dear. Here it is. The road to blank. The road to blank. The road to blank. We must have an answer soon.
Don't turn on us.
Okay, he's ready. Now, here we go. Cheryl, give us the answer that he's written down. We give you $5,000. The road to...
The road to... Oh, Phoenix. I can't think.
Oh, Phoenix is what she said.
Oh, it's hard. There were a lot of choices.
There really
what
were.
What were some of the good ones?
Oh,
on the road to Mandalay?
Road to Rio.
Road to happiness.
Road to ruin is what I would have said. Tab, what did you say?
Well, I said the road to success, the road to happiness, you know.
Road to success. Okay. All right, now, Cheryl, you didn't win the big money, but you've got $350. You're going to meet another player right now. Here comes Tina Ruggiero. Okay. Hello, Tina.
Hi, Gene.
How are you?
Fine. How are you?
I'm very well. Thank you for asking. Where are you from, honey?
I'm from Northridge, and I have a husband that I've been married to for 14 years and two children. And I'm happy to be here.
Well, we're happy to have you, Tina. Good luck to you. I guess you've seen this game. You know how it goes. You know that you have to make a choice here about A or B.
Okay, I'll take B.
B it is for Tina. Ready? Christopher Columbus says, faccia la finestra.
Was he Italian?
He says, now wait a minute. If this is a new land I'm going to discover, how come a beach is covered with blank? If it's a new land, how come a beach is covered with blank? You understand me, Tina?
I got it.
Hey, bella ragazza, Ruggiero, eh? If this is a new land I'm going to discover, how come the beach is covered with a blank? Well, wait a minute while I... Everybody ready over here. That's a good lady. Put it in the...
Honey, I've poked him. I've stomped on him. I've slapped him. I've done everything I can.
Okay, Tina. Christopher Columbus said, wait a minute. If this is a new land I'm going to discover, how come the beaches are covered with...
How about a lousy answer like sand?
Sand. Sand, you
There's
say.
Nothing new about it.
Well, what do you say?
I said oil slicks.
Oil slicks would be good. Yeah. Oil slicks is a good one. What?
I said if it's a new land, how come the beach is covered with beer cans?
Beer cans. Very good.
I knew you'd love it. It's yeah. The popular thing.
Yeah.
Being an environmentalist.
Beer cans.
Beer cans. You see, if he got there, and if no one had ever discovered it, it would be terrible if there were beer cans there. You do understand, don't you, Tina?
No.
I hope she understands. There's a fly in here. Get him out of here. I hate flies.
Let him get his own show.
Right. What do you say?
Well, beer cans, you know, the rest of it. Garbage.
Garbage is good.
Right. Oil.
Oil. Wonderful. Oil. Yes.
Oil.
Oil. Get that oil and garbage and beer can. Let's clean up our beaches and all that. Okay, you got the hang of it now, Tina. It's your last practice round here.
Good thinking.
Now we've got this message for you. Hurry back. Anything you say, John. Here we go. Other round one question for Cheryl Crisp reads as follows. Uh-oh. The phone company is really getting tough. It used to be that if you didn't pay your bill, they'd remove your phone. Now they send a guy to remove your blank. If you didn't pay your bill, they used to remove your phone. Now they send a guy to remove your blank. They're getting tough.
You see this? What is that?
Slack jaw.
Slack jaw with...
I remember the picture. Slack jaw.
Slack jaw, starring Humphrey Bogart.
I'm Humphrey Bogart.
Right. That's right. Who was the girl in it? I forgot.
It was Ida Lupino.
Ida Lupino, right.
And her dog, Trey.
Yes, right. Key Luke, he played a part
Key
in
Luke
it.
Key Luke
right.
was in it, too. That's
That's
true.
Right. Clara Bow, didn't she have a cameo
yes,
in it?
She did.
Yes, okay.
Excellent picture.
Hello, Cheryl.
Hello. My turn again.
It's your turn again. You don't want to play?
Oh yes, I do.
Wait
okay.
a minute. Wait a minute.
Oh. All right. While you're waiting, I'll kill the fly.
Okay, I'm all right. Sweetness, where'd you get that? Wolf fly swat.
It might be Vincent Price. Leave him alone.
Okay. The phone company's really getting tough. It used to be that if you didn't pay your bill, they came and removed your phone. Now they send a guy to remove your blank.
How about your teeth?
Your teeth. Little punch in the mouth. Remove your teeth. Okay. Ready? Go.
Now they remove your pole.
They remove the pole from this. Oh. Okay. What do you say?
I was in terrible trouble, so I had to do a little, but I mean, I'm not
You stole an answer is what you're saying. Pole. You stole his answer. When you steal a rotten answer, it's quite obvious.
Thanks, Jim.
I would have liked to have stolen his, yeah, his which is much better.
Mine's a tough, right? Isn't that the word, Gene?
They tough, right.
Hit him again. He likes it. I like that. Hit him again.
Okay. Let's see it.
Nurse! No. Dialing finger.
Dialing finger. Well, it's an amusing answer,
like
but doesn't get Cheryl
Paul.
Anything. She's looking for teeth. Head would be good. What do you say?
I said voice box.
I mean,
box.
Take off your head. Voice box, right. No, they send a guy to remove your head. He just...
No, he'd remove your ear.
Ear would be another one. That's not bad at all.
Good. Serves you right, too.
Have you got one?
Sure.
Ear. Okay. All right. No teeth there. Now we go to round two. Here we go. Tina, you ready?
Yes.
Go.
Oh, B.
B. All right. Here it is. Dumb Donald is so dumb. Once he buried his shoe because he wanted to grow a blank. Once he buried his shoe because he wanted to grow a blank. Oh, wait a minute. Don't move.
You got him?
No, he's right there.
Where is he?
Right there. Don't move.
Okay.
Have it.
Got him.
You did.
Wait a minute. Here he is. It's called a coup de grace.
You murderer.
He's dead. Yes.
The doctor says it's time for your bath.
Oh. All right. Let's go. Here we go. Whose turn is it?
What was the question?
What was the question? Dumb Donald is so dumb once he wanted to he buried his shoe because he wanted to grow a...
I've changed my mind.
Tina, are you ready? I'll read it slowly. Dumb Donald is so dumb, once he buried his shoe because he wanted to grow a...
Shoe tree?
Yeah! Very good. Shoe tree. Isn't that a nifty answer? Did anybody think of that?
No, I sure didn't.
You didn't think of that?
No. I thought of a webbed foot.
A webbed foot. It's back to Virginia in the horse farm tab.
Back to shoveling.
All right, Brett, what do you say?
Hi, hon.
Hello, darling. Oh, you got a rotten answer, too. Whenever she says, hi, hon, I know it's going to be a loser.
I think shoe tree's just a wonderful answer.
Excellent.
I thought he wanted to grow a sock.
No logical explanation for that.
Shoe tree,
how could you
but
think of that shoe tree? I mean, that's brilliant.
Brilliant is the word.
Absolutely.
Brilliant. Tina has one. He buried his shoe because he wanted to grow a shoe tree, Marilou. What do you say to
Tina
that?
Tina still has one. A sock.
A sock. All right.
I think the only other answer besides her brilliant answer, wanted to grow a corn.
A corn,
oh,
yeah.
Very good.
That's another good one, yes.
Thanks.
I bet you've got
I
a
like
Lulu,
it,
haven't
yes.
you there?
Thank you.
Fanny, honey,
yes.
You must have a good one.
Well, I thought everyone would have this.
You what?
Well, I'm confused because I thought he wanted to grow a foot.
Oh, wanted to grow taller.
Yeah.
He buried his shoe because he wanted to grow a foot taller. Well, okay. Now, here's the way it is, Cheryl. Oh, no, here's not the way it is. Cheryl, it's 1-0. We're in the middle of round two, and we're going to stop and do a little business with America. Okay, here we go. Next time we get together, these are the bodies you will see on this very stage.
David Doyle, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Deborah Lee Scott, Nipsey Russell, and Betty White.
Thank you all. You were wonderful. Gene Rayburn joins next time. Match Game 78. Goodbye.